Welcome, everybody. Thanks for joining us for NBA action on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and a pair of Hall of Famers with us, Doris Burke and David Aldridge. We've got the Brooklyn Nets and the Chicago Bulls. And so off the tip, it's Brooklyn. So the Nets starting five. We've got Durant, Spencer Dinwiddie out there with Kyrie Irving. Then there's DeAndre Jordan, and it's Allen in at the four slot. Now here's Dinwiddie, and a wide open look for Irving. A three-pointer, no good. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's on Kevin Durant.
Five. Elbow. Two.
The Bulls shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one.
Two shots.
Shooting two.
And that one falls for Harper. And he makes the first, but misses the second. Dinwiddie passes to Durant, and then Durant with the dunk.
Well, how about that floor awareness by Spencer Dinwiddie, getting his guys the basketball in great spots.
Inside, Jordan falls back and drains the fadeaway jumper.
Poor design there defensively. They know he's a knockdown shooter from that spot.
That's not coming with the right mentality. The defender neither closes the space nor challenges the shot. That's frustrating as a coach, boy.
Here's Dinwiddie, following the basket by Michael Jordan. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. I was able to speak with Chicago's head coach. And it's no secret they have to contain Kevin Durant. The problem is, even with a hand in his face, KD's tall enough to knock it down. Coach said, you just hope he misses. True words. Kevin?
Thanks, David.
That's another miss. Already they've missed three out of four to start. Gives the team such a great element, having a one guard who can get to the 10.
Certainly something every team wants to have.
Oh, you love it, Kevin. Fearless, aggressive, leaving no doubt whatsoever.
Dinwiddie against Jordan. High, arcing shot. Rebound, Brooklyn.
And he has definitely been struggling in this quarter.
And you know what? They keep calling his number, and they're simply trying to get him out of this funk.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. Oh, the lob to Irving. Off they go on a three-on-one break. A huge slam, the perfect end of the fast break.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Fresh from a win against the Nuggets.
And if you look at the box score from that game, guys, the first thing you'll notice is how many turnovers they forced.
Now, I think that's a product of being incredibly aggressive. You could see that was a part of their strategy going in. And I thought they were consistently following that the entire game.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Here is Durant. And the rejection by Pippen.
And it's always been about the effort defensively for Pippen, known as a stopper and a fantastic shot blocker to boot.
This guy, a tough cover for any defender. Creative and assertive scoring the ball.
For Chicago, they have gone 1-for-2 on the night so far from the line. Free throw good, Jordan.
And the defining trait of the greatest of superstars, Jordan makes the players around him better, mentally, in terms of effort, and in terms of their performance.
Now here's Irving, out to KD to end the run. They get it back. Allen, that's in, and he found his range with that one. Now 1-for-2.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Pass to Jordan. And Jordan sends it back.
This is not the guy you want in your zip code when the ball is going up. DeAndre Jordan twice on the pipes.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
All the officials are all over that one.
The Nets shooting their first free throws of the game.
And they've shot the ball well this season in terms of their attempts, 81%.
The first one falls.
I think Kevin Durant, it's obvious how much passion and pride he takes in playing the game at the highest level. It is such an honor watching this guy work.
That one misses.
Let's give some credit to the defense for how they're guarding this guy right now, because they're refusing to let him get comfortable.
And it's out of bounds. The Nets will take it the other way.
Listen, turnovers happen. You've got to move on to the next play.
Nets trail by 5. And on the way from Irving for 3, and he's good on the 3-ball.
Now, don't sleep on Kyrie Irving's perimeter game. Yes, he can get inside and score at will, but, boy, you better check that jumper.
To the inside. And there's the block. Just stops it cold and takes possession. Here's KD. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. Down low. And slam dunk by Jordan.
Well, Kyrie Irving has such a good sense of when his teammates are going to create an opportunity, and he puts the pass on time and on target.
Now here's Jordan. He has 5. Now Longley. 6 on the shot clock. Outside for Jordan. From deep three-point range, it's hauled in by DeAndre Jordan. Jordan's got 4 rebounds in this game. A nice shot by Irving.
Well, the defense was there. It just simply didn't matter to Kyrie Irving. This guy makes a living hitting contested shots.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago.
And momentum going the other way. Can they find some answers?
I think here you have just got to get back to what you do best and then live with the results.
Here's Jordan. He has five. Outside Harper. Kicks to Pippen. That one's off. Still out of sync. The Nets with the lead. Pass to KD. Here's Jordan. Scottie Pippen grabs the miss. To the paint, Longley. It doesn't go for him. And Brooklyn will now go the other way with it. This is his first free throw of the game.
Shooting two.
First one falls for. That one falls, so he hits both of them. There's Dinwiddie. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Pass to Irving. Back to Dinwiddie. Allen outside. Clock at six. And the pass to KD. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it. And here's Pippen. Outside Jordan. Shoots over Dinwiddie. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him.
Taking back the lead once more. Give these teams credit. Man, they are battling.
Boy, Greg, neither team willing to give an inch, and neither able to seize the momentum. This has been a fascinating one to watch.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. Six to shoot. Offensive rebound. Allen, that's good.
You know what? That's all about hustle and a nose for the basketball. Tremendous job on the offensive glass by Jared Allen.
Harper the pass to Rodman. Back to Harper. And stolen by Irving. It's Allen on the wing. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Nets shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. And the first one at the line is good.
And, guys, I think the future is so bright for Jared Allen. We're talking about an athletic, mobile big man who has already proven to be an accomplished two-way player.
Tony Kukoc, he's checked in for Chicago. And Allen drops them both. Here's Harper. He's got five. He kicks it to Pippen. Jordan against Dinwiddie. Outside Jordan. Shot clock at six. Dinwiddie with some nice D.
Boy, this guy is a good finisher, so he misses a chippy. That's tough to take.
Over Kukoc, and Dinwiddie gets it to go on the assist by Irving.
Listen, this guy has got good touch and solid shooting stroke. Spencer Dinwiddie comfortable in the catch and shoot.
Pippen, the pass to Longley. Jordan inside. Dinwiddie covering. For three, Pippen. The rebound by the Nets. Allen's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Irving drives in. And another shot. Jordan trying to free himself up. Irving can't get it to go. Last outing for the Bulls, it was a loss to the Bucks in Milwaukee. And a wide open look for Jordan. And it's Durant with the rebound.
Boy, he'll usually knock it down if he's left that wide open. Just comes up empty.
Pops it up for Jordan. Hammers the alley-oop through.
DeAndre Jordan, simply a force around the cup. This guy has rare athleticism.
Irving against Harper. Pass to Jordan. And they double up Jordan. Pippen for three. Good on the triple.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Here's Irving. He has five. And the Nets with possession. They're on an 18-7 run. It's Jordan on the wing. Back to Irving. Ball's knocked loose. Here's Pippen. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
The three from KD. And the Nets, another three.
Gets one to fall, but only his second make in the first seven attempts.
Kukoc against Allen. Kukoc passes along. Clock at six. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Last outing for the Bulls, it was a loss to Milwaukee. Fires from deep. Scottie Pippen grabs the miss.
Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
Harper's shot's good. Irving with it. Passes it to Allen. Over Kukoc. Here's Jordan, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That one on Pippen.
Well, DeAndre Jordan making his presence felt at the offensive end. Nice.
The Nets have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point. Throw good, Jordan.
Well, you know what DeAndre Jordan is going to bring to the table every night. Great effort, incredible presence on the backboards, a ton of length defensively. Love everything he does for you.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Williams, he's checked in for Longley. Harris comes in for Michael Jordan. And Kerr subbed in for Harper. And so Jordan nails both of them. Bulls trail by six. Outside Pippen. At the elbow, Williams. Shot clock at five. Harris outside. Kerr, the pass to Williams. For three, Pippen. Dinwiddie with the rebound.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
And DeAndre Jordan throws it down.
Well, we've seen that a time or two for Mr. DeAndre Jordan. Nice, easy finish with that dunk.
Kerr, the pass to Harris. There's the lob to the hoop, and it's Pippen slamming it down.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
There's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop.
And I'm not sure that is a shot that he should be taking.
Well, it's hard to imagine that the play was designed to go in that direction. Boy, I'd be surprised if we see that again.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
The Nets have shot 5 of 6 at the foul line tonight. And that one falls for Prince. Garrett Temple has checked in for Jordan. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Bulls. They trail by 7. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting 2.
2 shots.
And you look at Kerr, just a sharp shooting role player. 2. His game really about guts and intelligence.
Bulls have only 1 missed free throw. They've had 5 attempts and made 4 of them.
Shooting 2.
That one is off. The Nets making a switch here. Irving's checked in. Good on the second free throw. Brooklyn leading by 6. 54 seconds left to play in the first quarter. From deep, connects from 3-point range. Irving's got 8 points.
Oh, just tremendous range from Kyrie. If he steps across a half-court line, you better have a hand up.
Harris passes to Pippen. Kukoc against Prince. Kukoc kicks to Harris. A floater. Another shot. No good that time. The Nets go the other way with it. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Harris dishes to Temple. Prince the pass to Irving. From deep 3-point range, the shot no good. He got it up. The shot no good. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Nets out in front, up by 9. And we'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And, guys, what stands out to you from the Nets in this one?
Guys, I love their defense in that first period. They were in position and just challenging shots.
Well, I think they combined great intelligence with great effort, and you can see the results.
Bulls trail by 9. And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So for Chicago right now, we've got Williams. Kukoc is out there with Pippen. Then it's Kerr, and it's Harris in at the 2. Kerr can't hit.
He is too good a shooter, guys, to be left open like that. The defense just dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. Here's Pippen after the basket by Brooklyn. The rebound by Prince. Some solid defense from Pippen.
Great rim protection to prevent him from converting. Beautiful.
Here's Harris. No good there.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's Irving. Nice shot from 10 feet out. Irving's got the lead up to 13 now for the Nets.
The evolution of Kyrie Irving's game continues. Magnificent with the jumper.
Pippen kicks to Kukoc. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. And he's got his first free throw of the game.
Tony Kukoc, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. Dennis Rodman, he's checked in for Pippen. Kukoc hits them both. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Nets leading by 11. Irving looking for an opening. Prince against Kerr. Prince dishes to Harris. Five on the clock. Here's Temple. Cranes it from beyond the arc. Temple's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
Well, that's a case where your teammates are showing trust in you, and he comes through with flying colors.
Kukoc against Harris. That is good. And the Nets' lead is cut down to just 12 points with the basket from Kukoc. Irving passes to Claxton. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Here's Prince. Chicago grabs the miss. Williams has got 4 rebounds now tonight. To the middle. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
Yeah, and what you love about Kukoc, the versatility on offense and the terrific court vision.
And Temple kicks to Prince. Goes, jamming that one home.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury.
He rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish. Here's Harris. Rebound, Brooklyn.
You know, you can't impact a shot that close any better than he did on that possession.
Boy, whether he blocks it or simply alters it, the result is pretty much the same.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alder.
Well, Kevin, Kenny Atkinson, who's a native of Long Island, now has his dream job, coaching the Brooklyn Nets. He doesn't need praise or recognition. Instead, he's fueled by the fear of failure. He says, I always feel like I'm one banana peel away from never being in the NBA again. And Kevin, he's got his team playing with that same determination.
David, he sure does. Thank you very much. The Nets have gone 6 of 8 from the free throw line tonight. Free throw good from Kyrie Irving.
What's incredible to me is Kyrie Irving at 6'3". Does he possess incredible eye-popping athleticism? No. But he can create his own shot anytime he wants, and his finishing ability is as good as it gets in the NBA.
And they get it back. Moves back up. Williams' shot is off.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Harris outside. Outside Irving. Here's Temple, guarded by Harris. Brooklyn needs to get off a shot here. Irving misses.
He has that confidence rolling, hitting 2 threes in the first, but he hasn't had one since.
Harris passes to Kukoc. Now the dish to Williams. It's hauled in by Claxton.
Great contest by the defender, but that's a dunk you've got to put down in his face.
Harris kicks to Irving. Over Kerr. Irving misses.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
Kerr with it, picked up by Harris. And stolen by Harris. Oh, and a fast break for the Nets. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. Temple's got 5 points now in the quarter.
We so often identify Joe Harris as strictly a shooter, but this guy, he is a tremendous passer as well.
Kukoc dishes to Williams. A second chance effort. It's hauled in by Claxton. Claxton's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Boy, Joe Harris refusing to give an inch, and he is rewarded with a trip to the free throw line. Nicely done.
The Nets have made 7 out of 9 when they've stepped to the line. That free throw, no good.
Now you think about it, over time, Joe Harris has made himself a viable option as an NBA player. He's got such offensive versatility.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Longley's checked in for Williams. Jordan comes in for Kukoc. And it's Harper in for Steve Kerr. And then for Brooklyn, Jared Allen's checked in for Prince. Kevin Durant comes in for Garrett Temple. And Dinwiddie subbed in for Irving. Bulls trail by 16. Outside, Rodman. Pass to Jordan. Over Durant. And there's Jordan. That's good on the assist from Rodman. Jordan's got 9.
And as much as he's done to increase the range on his jump shot, this is where Jordan's bread is buttered, that mid-range game.
Now here is Harris. And that one drops. And the Nets lead by 16. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Harris passes to Longley. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Taking 2 shots.
Take a break. 2 shots.
No good on that one. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the Nets. And the second free throw, good. And so it's Dinwiddie who brings up the ball for the Brooklyn Nets. There's the pass to Durant. Misses the 3.
He couldn't believe how open he was. He just couldn't convert it.
Harris kicks to Jordan. Back to Harris from the corner. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Harris has got his first bucket in this one.
Yeah, and this is what happens when you have a scorer like Jordan on the floor. He attracts all that attention defensively, leaving guys wide open.
Now here's Allen. He's got 6. Shoots a fader. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Bulls trail by 13. Harris dishes to Harper. Back to Harris. Here's Jordan. And Durant sends it back.
Boy, the long arms of Kevin Durant twice on the pipes.
Harris, right side.
Just doesn't seem to have it here in the second quarter.
Misses the step back jump shot.
Boy, it's been a struggle in this quarter, and the team needs more from him. There's no doubt.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
And you know how that plays gonna end. Jordan in the air, adjusting effortlessly.
Pass to Jordan. Dinwiddie against Harper. They get a hand on it. Dinwiddie's shot is off.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
We call that a great contest. You know, this is something he brings to the table, the ability to anchor your defense.
Now, here's Dinwiddie after Devin Harris's miss. And DeAndre Jordan throws it down.
Jordan's confidence has just grown over the course of his career. DeAndre, for much of it, averaged less than 5 points per game, especially those first couple of years. Look at him now.
Now here's Jordan. He's got 11. And here we go. Harris heading to the hoop. Drops in the breakaway layup. Harris has got 5 now.
Boy, nice job by Joe Harris to sprint the floor and finish. That is beautiful.
Harper kicks to Harris. Outside, Rodman. It's Jordan on the wing. Outside, Durant. That's good from Harris on the assist by Dinwiddie. Dinwiddie's got 4 assists now tonight. Bulls trail by 19. Outside, Harper shoots over Dinwiddie. And that one hits back iron. One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent passing.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Here's Harris. And the foul called on Jared Allen. That is his first foul of the game. Chicago making a switch here. Pippen's checked in.
Coming off the floor for your Bulls, Scottie Pippen.
And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Pippen's got his 3rd basket of the night.
And he is just so tough to guard. He can fake you one way and then use that beautiful spin to just blow by you.
Passes it to Dinwiddie. 1:43 left in the second quarter. Just 5 to shoot. Shoots. He scores the basket. That's field goal number 3 for him.
I'm not sure what he was thinking exactly, but he finds a way to convert.
KD against Jordan. There's 1:17 left to play in the first half. And it's sent back by Allen.
Boy, you've got to watch those long arms of Jared Allen. Twice on the pipe, send it back. And after nailing a 3-pointer in the first quarter, he has yet to connect here in the second.
Harris finds Dinwiddie. Harris against Pippen. Pass to Allen. Here's Jordan. And 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. And let's see what the Nets have coming up. On Monday, they'll be taking on Victor Oladipo and the Indiana Pacers. And then on Wednesday, they'll host the Charlotte Hornets.
And looking at this stretch for them, I think they should have no problem dispatching most of their opponents. If they can avoid that pitfall of playing down to the level of the competition, but that's easier said than done.
No good on the free throw. Thank you. And he's good on the second. Bulls trail by 20. Outside Jordan. Over Durant. Rebound Brooklyn. Allen's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. And stolen by Jordan. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Harper's shot. Good. Harper's got 9.
Well, offensively, this guy has been cooking. They're definitely not losing because of him.
Now here's Durant. He has 6. It's tipped. It's stolen by Rodman. And through one half, it hasn't even been close. Nets lead by 18. Time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us, but you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. It's Brooklyn out in front at the half. They are in control of this game, up by 18. Kenny, what did you see from them?
I love the way they're getting after it in the paint. Moving bodies, attacking the rim, scoring at will. Sometimes teams try to hurt you with the three ball. They went right for the heart of the defense. Look at them to keep pounding it inside and staying physical.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
Well, first of all, as cold as they've been from the floor, I can't say I'm surprised by the score. You cannot shoot the ball that poorly and expect to be in the game. They need better ball movement. If their offense stays this stagnant, they could forget about a comeback.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
And you know he's going to put up points every time out, but boy, he made it look so easy in that first half.
And let's see if he continues that trend the rest of the way. He certainly has the talent and the endurance to do just that.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Checking out the group for Kenny Atkinson to start the second half. Durant is out there with Allen. Then it's Jordan. Then there's Spencer Dinwiddie. And it's Irving at the one. Now here's Dinwiddie following the miss by Michael Jordan. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Nets will retain possession. Bulls on D. Durant, the pass to Dinwiddie. That's good, and it's KD with the assist. KD's got 3 assists in the game. Outside Rodman. And it's sent back by Allen. Dinwiddie kicks to Allen. And it's Allen with the jam.
Well, Jared Allen putting it on the deck and getting to the cup. Big man doing work.
Harper the pass to Rodman. Dishes to Jordan. Shoots over Dinwiddie. And again, no good by Chicago.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Count that bucket.
3 for 3, and that's always a good way to start the second half.
Outside Jordan. Kicks it to Harper. To stop the run. Some solid defense there from Irving.
Not a terrific start here in the second half. 4 attempts, nothing to show for it.
That shot missing. Good work defensively by Pippen.
They tried to stay perfect in the half, but 3 for 4 now.
A shot by Jordan, no good.
Oof, ugly start to the second half. They're still scoreless in their first five attempts.
Count it, good. And that's now 11 points for Spencer Dinwiddie.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Irving against Pippen. No good from Irving.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And what you love about his work defensively, the ability to challenge and change shots without fouling.
Now, here's Durant. Dennis Rodman missing his last shot. And stolen by Jordan. Harper against Durant. Harper kicks to Jordan. The pass to Longley. Over Irving. Longley with the bucket. Longley's got five. Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Dinwiddie surveying the floor. Jordan, the pass to Dinwiddie. Back to Jordan. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Jordan's gone a nice 5 of 6 shooting from the field. Pippen, the pass to Jordan. Irving against Harper, pulls it from the elbow. And he overshot that one, missing.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
And slam dunk by Allen. That gives him the double-double, 10 points and 14 rebounds.
Well, this guy has got tremendous length and hops. Jared Allen makes it easy.
Harper kicks to Pippen. Over Durant. It's stolen by Allen. And here's the fast break. Durant leading the way.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Pippen, the pass to Jordan. Teardrop shot, and it's good on the way in. 13 points in the game.
And what you like there, Jordan never looks like he's rushing. Makes quick, solid decisions.
Here's Allen, and he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Pass to Jordan. The kick out to Harper. Pass to Pippen. Launches a three. Dinwiddie with the rebound. And so it's Dinwiddie with it. He'll bring it up for the Nets. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Here's Jordan. Trying to get open as Pippen. And it's blocked by Jordan. Durant wide open. He fires. Rebounded by Rodman. Rodman's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Pass to Harper. Puts it up from 17. Doesn't go that time. And it's the Nets taking it the other way. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group here. Williams, he's checked in for Longley. Kukoc comes in for Dennis Rodman. Devin Harris has checked in for Scottie Pippen. And Kerr subbed in for Harper. Here's Temple. 5 points in the game. A pass to Claxton. A three ball. 6 on the shot clock. And Kerr pulls it down.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Outside, Kukoc. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. And here's Harris from the arc. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Brooklyn with the ball. They're on a 17-4 run right now. Irving passes to Claxton. Prince outside. That shot, no good. Kukoc with the defensive effort. Harris drives in. He can't get that one to fall. And stolen by Harris. Takes the elbow jumper and drains it. Harris has got his second bucket of the night. Now, Dinwiddie. He's got 11. He kicks to Prince. He dishes it to Irving. From 12 feet out, Chicago grabs the miss. Williams has got 7 rebounds in the game. Here's Jordan. Drops one in from the wing. Jordan's got 4 this quarter.
Yeah, nice timing there on that catch and shoot. Jordan with such a musical rhythm to his game.
Timeout called, the Nets.
For viewers, timeout's a chance to check your phone, grab a drink, but for the teams, it's all about business.
Well, there's something that the coach doesn't like. I'm curious to see which kind of adjustment he makes here.
Joe Harris is checked in for Dinwiddie. On the wing, Irving, defended by Kerr. Unloads from 13. It's hauled in by the Bulls. No good that time. And Brooklyn will come the other way. Pass to Temple. Back to Harris. And here is Irving. 15 points in the game. Clock at 4 to the paint. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. And the Nets miss again.
Well, he had the defense's attention, dropping 2 threes in the first half, but he hasn't made one since.
Harris against Harris. Here's Jordan. And good coming on the assist from Devin Harris. And that's 17 points for Michael Jordan.
And you can just see the extraordinary competitiveness. MJ staying laser focused after absorbing the contact.
Now, here is Irving. The 10-footer finds the target. Irving's got 17 now. Chicago with the ball. Kerr with it. Outside, Kukoc. Here's Jordan. And it's Irving with the rebound.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
I think expect them to go back to it, because that's the kind of shot this offense is designed to generate. He needs to look to try to drive inside and get going. That outside shot is simply not there.
And the basket by Harris.
Yeah, that's just straightforward basketball from Harris. Driving to the hoop with purpose and not letting anyone, or anything for that matter, slow him down.
Now here's Irving. 17 points in the game. Here's Claxton. Back to Irving. Fires the 3. Offensive rebound. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Michael Jordan. The Nets have gone 9 of 13 from the line.
Claxton at the line for 2.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
Yeah. first one falls for him. And he makes both free throws. Now, here's Kerr. Kicks it to Harris. Outside, Kukoc. Six to shoot. Let's go. The rebound by the Nets.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Looking to get it going. Irving misses. And the Bulls with possession. A minute 50 left here in the third quarter. Harris outside. Three-pointer. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Harris has got 9 points.
Wow, he looks like a completely different player in this half. He's found his rhythm.
Irving passes to Prince. That's tipped, so it looks like the Nets will retain possession here. Longley's checked in for Chicago. And a switch here for Brooklyn. Jordan's checked in. .124 left to play in the third. Shot clock at 6. Here's Claxton. Rebound by the Bulls. Longley's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Harris against Irving. A nice shot by Harris.
Boy, it seems like every shot he puts up, it's going in. This guy is hot. Hot!
Irving against Kerr. Takes a 3. And that's good. Kyrie Irving for 3. Irving's got 20 points.
His first triple of the second half. That makes 3 for the game.
Kerr kicks to Jordan. Let's a floater go. He takes it up and lays it in.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Passes to Irving. It's stolen by Kerr. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Jordan finds Harris. Over Claxton. Harris, no good.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Well, missed opportunities, and they can certainly add up. You cannot afford to take that kind of shot.
And so it's Brooklyn, riding high with a 23-point lead heading into the break. They have made it very tough to get a shot off against them. Their defense has been stifling. Back right after this. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
And, Greg, nothing better than chemistry, right? Working together to create a bucket.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. Tony Kukoc is out there with Longley. Then there's Harper. Then it's Pippen. And it's Kerr. And at the shooting guard position. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. Jordan. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up. Helps teams if they can keep the rights to their best player. We see it in other leagues. Could the franchise tag? ever make its way, do you think, to the NBA?
Well, this is going to be a negotiation point between the Players Association and the league itself. And the reality is it's going to have to be negotiated. What we know unequivocally, Kevin, is that these players now in the player empowerment era have more control about what franchise they play for and how long the duration of their contract is. How this all shakes out remains to be seen, but it is a point of conversation amongst the 30 NBA teams and the league leadership. There's no question about it.
Free throw good, Jordan. And Brooklyn making a change here. Allen's checked in. And so Jordan nails both of them.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Pass to Kerr. Here's Bippen. And there's the pass to Longley. Just five on the clock. And that's going to be a travel.
Much better job of just taking care of the basketball, really putting the onus on the defense.
So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group here. Wennington, he's checked in for Longley. Simpkins comes in for Tony Kukoc. Bushler's checked in for Scottie Pippen. And Smith subbed in for Ron Harper. A big group substitution here for Brooklyn. Wilson Chandler's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Rodions Kurucs comes in for Kevin Durant. Musa, he's checked in for Harris. And it's Luwawu Cabarro in for Kyrie Irving. And the shot goes in from Kurucs.
Boy, that's beautiful touch on the floater. And let's remember, not everyone has that shot in their arsenal.
A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. Smith, the pass to Bushler. Here's Wennington. He's guarded by Chandler. Smith fires from way outside. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation.
You know, Doris, you and I love history. And we were talking the other day, you and I, about Bill Russell and his 11 championship rings. You think anyone's ever going to break that record?
I think it'll be close to impossible, Kevin. And the reason is, number one, there were so many fewer teams back then for Bill Russell. In no way diminishing the greatness of one of the game changers, both between the lines and outside the lines. Bill Russell will always be an historic figure. But it's very tough to compare eras. There's now 30 teams, nutrition, conditioning, coaching. There's just so much more information in the current era.
And so here is Chicago. After the basket by Brooklyn, here's Bushler. And a miss there on the triple. Here's Luwawu, covered by Smith. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Yeah, easy call.
Two shots, first foul. Two.
Shooting for Brooklyn. Rodions Kurucs. Two shots.
Shooting two.
The first one falls. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Doris, it seems like Adam Silver, the NBA commissioner, is one of the most well-liked commissioners in all of sports worldwide. Why do you think that's so?
Well, I think he was amongst the most important members of the staff of his predecessor, David Stern, who obviously oversaw the greatest growth in NBA history. The NBA became a global game. But Adam Silver didn't skip a beat. He is a great listener, a great communicator. And I've said this about the NBA for a very long time. It is a league that is in constant self-evaluation process. It is always looking for ways to improve the league, whether that means organizationally or with the play between the lines, and that's all you can ask for, Kevin.
Kerr's shot is good.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
It takes incredible effort to stay connected to the hip of the offensive player. You've got to want to work.
Here's Garuch. Plays it up and banks it in.
Well, they're calling his number time and time again, and he is delivering.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for Chicago. Here's Winnington. And it's sent back by Allen. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Allen. And here are the Bulls now. Now Kerr. Pass to Simpkins. Six on the shot clock. Here's Smith. The Bulls keep it alive. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Doris, when you look at the success of international players, and the league has a litany of very good international players, Doncic being the latest success story, is the perception changing about these kids when they come from overseas and play in the NBA?
Well, one of the greatest, and to me, the greatest international player of all time, Dirk Nowitzki, a Hall of Fame player, probably changed the perception to start with. Now, listen, over the years, Luka is going to have perhaps a Hall of Fame career if he stays healthy. The reality is this. The NBA is looking for the best players to man those 15 roster spots of the 30 NBA teams. It doesn't matter where you're from, what the color of your skin is. If you can play the game of basketball and play it at the highest level, the NBA wants you to be a part of their league.
Here's Luau. Passes it to Karuch. Down low, deflects the pass. Allen finds Chandler. Here's Luau to the inside. Allen, that's good.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now, here is Smith. Pass to Winnington. Back to Smith. Now the pass to Winnington. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Simpkins, no good. And the Nets with possession. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Luella. Here's Musa. Passes it to Luella. No good with the triple. Smith surveying the D. Doris, in 2004, the Charlotte Bobcats became the NBA's 30th team. When do you think we're going to see another team added, whether it's an expansion or even multiple expansion cities?
Well, let's go directly to the most important source, and that's Commissioner Adam Silver, who has said that expansion is inevitable, but right now not a huge priority. So, you know, listen, we've heard Seattle is on the short list of cities that wants to get a team, and what a great city, what a great NBA fan base. I hope someday we get back to Seattle.
So much history up there. You're correct. Garrett Temple has checked in for the Nets. Here's Musa. Misses off the left iron.
Listen, he can make that shot right there, but I do know they have other options they can go to.
Smith, the pass to Winnington. And here's Smith. Pass to Kerr. Clock at six. From deep. The rebound by Wilson Chandler. Here's Karuch. Temple, the pass to Musa. and the layup's good off the glass.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now, here is Smith. The pass to Kerr. Let's it go with a three. The shot, no good. The Nets go the other way with it. Pass to Karuch. Buschler with the rebound.
Boy, defense nowhere to be found, and neither was his shot at that time.
Smith outside. A lot of people look at that general manager position with the team. I think it grows with some organization, maybe shrinks in importance with others. But by and large, it is more stable than coaching, isn't it? That position of being a GM.
Yeah, and I think, Kevin, if you were to ask coaches, one of the things I've heard sort of thrown out there as an idea is when you list the head coach's record, why not list the GM's record as well? Because the reality is success in the NBA is contingent on so many things. What's your ownership like? What kind of front office personnel? Have they made great decisions? Do you have the best possible coaching comparative to the talent on your roster? So much contributes to winning, Kevin.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
And he makes the first. Seeing some great shooters with length, tall players shooting from outside. That seems to be the rage right now. But when you look in your crystal ball, Doris, what might be the next player trend in the NBA?
So we saw the evolution of big men as three-point shooters, men being able to enter the league as sort of back to the basket, consistent rebounding forces out of the post, now stepping away and becoming threats as face-up scorers. To me, one of the most intriguing young players in the league right now is Nikola Jokic. Here's a 7-foot guy who is a tremendous playmaker. His instinct is to pass more than it is to score. So you wonder, is that the next evolution of big men? And then the other thing, Kevin, you are starting to see offensive rebounding went away as a focal point of teams in the NBA. You are starting to see teams go back after the offensive glass. Does that continue?
Second chance is a big statistic, isn't it?
It is.
Here's Kerr, following the bucket by the Nets. Takes the three. Rebound, Brooklyn. Claxton's got six rebounds now in the game. Here's Luwawu, defended by Kerr. The fader. Chandler, no good.
Listen, offensively, they're very comfortable with him taking that shot. It's a good look under very little pressure. He just can't convert.
Here's Buschler. Some of these players are making more money on endorsement deals than on their NBA contracts. I mean, I just shake my head at that, don't you?
It's an amazing time in which we live because the power of social media and the understanding of today's athlete that their brand is significant and that their brand extends outside of the lines of competition. You see so many men who have overseas opportunities, whether you're talking Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, Donovan Mitchell. They understand the power of the face and the talents they bring to the table. Truly, truly remarkable young men.
Remarkable indeed.
No, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
That's his first personal foul. Shooting. Claxton. Two shots.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. That one is no good. Now, here's Kerr. He's tightly guarded. Yep, it counts.
Good job attacking. Those restricted area shots are what every NBA team is looking for.
Temple, the pass to Karuch. Dwyer, when you look at draft eligibility requirements, it is a very fluid topic with a lot of different ways it could go, a lot of moving parts. Where do you stand?
I'll tell you the truth, Kevin. I'm conflicted about this because I believe there is real value to the college experience. There's high-level coaching across the game at the collegiate level. But I also believe that young men who have talent should be able to, when they are eligible, decide when they want to become professionals. So, listen, I'm sort of in the middle. There are legitimate arguments to be had for both sides. What I hope, regardless, is we get the best players in the league, and that's certainly going to happen whenever it happens.
And Brooklyn has possession after the Bulls pick up two. With the floater, rebounded by Wennington. Wennington's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Smith up top. Passes it to Wennington. Here's Simpkins. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Pass to Smith. Over Temple. And that one goes long. Smith's gone 1 of 6 shooting so far. And Temple kicks to Luwawu Cabarro. Here's Karuch. The pass to Chandler. Over Kerr. Chandler's shot good. Chandler's got his first points of the night. And that put a hush over the crowd.
Wow, I mean, took these fans out of the game in the blink of an eye.
Pass to Kerr. Fires the three. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Musa, he's checked in for Garrett Temple. Here's Smith, laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
This is what we call highly efficient play. Working off the screen, getting to the cup.
55 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Passes to Karuch. This one for three. And that's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession.
Brooklyn ball.
Here's Luwawu. Off target at the rim. There's 37 seconds left in the game. Buschler, the pass to Wennington. Simpkins, the second chance points on the tip in.
Hard work and soft hands. Guys, that's what made that play possible.
No simple offensive rebound there. Going for the tip in. Here's Karuch. And he comes up with the deuce.
But the truth is, they've had control of this game.
And I couldn't agree more. What makes it that much more impressive, they're doing it on the road.
Kerr with it. And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long and good night, everyone.